Happy New Year! Yes, yes, it is 2024. We in there, y'all. We are in a brand new year. God has kept us. We have crossed over into not just a new year, but I don't want to keep saying all things new, but it for is. Us, live, live. We're moving into all things new. We are, fortunately. So we all know that you all are waiting on updates, and we promised to give you updates. So I'm going to give you that in just a second. I do want to share. Look at you, because you don't know.
Nope, I don't know. Well,
let's do the update first. Let's do the update, y'all. As you know, man, we are moving. Liv has a home now.
Yep.
So we're excited about moving. We're excited about starting there fresh. I'm excited about going back to one service.
Yeah.
11:30.
That's the one.
Thank you, Jesus.
If Pastor want me there, we're going to have it at 11:30.
Y'all see how you do? All right, so we want to give you all an update. Praise the Lord. We will be getting the keys January the 10th. January the 10th, we get the keys to our facility. And then from that point on, y'all know me. I already told y'all, hey, we in there. First Sunday of the new year. I know I said all of that because me, I'm like, get it and go. But y'all remember when I cut my face, right? Yeah, the Lord said, Ty, slow down. So we're going to slow down. We're not going to rush any of this. We're not going to rush the process at all. We're going to be wise. We're going to be excellent. And we're going to take the keys January the 10th. Praise the Lord. Thank God for that. And then we're going to take 10 weeks to prepare, to build, to move. We'll talk about that in a little bit. So we'll have our first service in our new building, Palm Sunday, March the 21st. 2024. Yes. That's right, y'all. So we will reopen Palm Sunday, March 21st, 2024. Up until then, the work of the Lord will still be being done. We still will be airing every Sunday. We still will be bringing you a word and periodically giving you updates. So please make sure you are locked in to Live. Make sure you're on our mailing list, our text, everything.
Checking out the website. Definitely always go to the website. When you don't know where to go, go to the website.
That's livechurchorlando.com. Livechurchorlando.com. It should be on the screen right now. Stay connected with us, y'all, because we want you all to know how we're moving, when we're moving, and what we're doing, and how you could help. Okay? So it's not that we're just going to be sitting until the 21st.
That's right.
It's time to work. That's what I want to show y'all. That's why I got to break out my phone. You know how every top of the year, you know, I kind of pray, ask the Lord what the focus of the year would be and stuff like that. So, Liv, you know, or if you may not know, I always look up the year in scripture, okay? So, like, 2024, Genesis 2024, Exodus 2024, whatever. Check this out, y'all. Leviticus 2024 says this, "But I have said unto you, ye shall inherit the land, and I will give it unto you to possess it. A land that floweth with milk and honey. I am the Lord your God, which have separated you from other people." It's talking about possessing land in the year 2024. I couldn't believe that. I was so excited. And to me, it spoke directly to Live and what we're doing and what we're coming into. Wait. Joel 2, verse 24 says, "And the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fat shall overflow with wine and oil." So we're not just coming into a land or a new building. It's going to be prosperous. Amen.
Amen.
Here's the last one I want to share with y'all, then I'm going to turn you loose. Haggai 2, verse 4 says, "Yet now be strong, saith the Lord. Be strong, O Joshua, son of..." Watch this. "And all the people of the land, saith the Lord, and work, for I am with you." Whoa, so I'm giving you land. It's going to be prosperous, but you got to work. We got work to do. So Liv, this is a prosperous year for us. It's a year we possess land. It's a year we're excited of what the Lord has given unto our hands. Yet it's not a time to be lax. It's not a time to take a break. It's not a time to recline and chill.
Right.
It's a time to put our hand to the plow and work. So during these 10 weeks, it's not a vacation for anybody. It's time to, if you consider yourself a member of Liv Church, put your hand to the plow and help us build what God has called us to establish in Orlando. What we got? Pinte.
To me, it's easier to sow than to reap. Mm. So we have to learn how to reap, and I'm hearing harvest, and this is a type of harvest. Mm. And so we need workers to even gather, gather anything. We need more people to gather what we need. And so like we did before when we moved from the Holy Land, we had different teams. So Pastor and I really would pray and hope that you all would be, you know, there to
partners
help.
Partner with us, yeah.
Yeah, partner with us. We have different tiers. We have people who packed up. So we have people coming in, some people putting stamps on things, people packing up. Then we have people driving. We have people getting there and unpacking. So these 10 weeks, we need this time. We need time to prepare.
Yep.
And we want to do it right this time. And so that's why Pastor's saying slow down.
Yep.
God is saying take your time so that all the ministries and everybody can take their time to replenish themselves, to renew their minds, and also to figure out what they want to do as to helping LiVe Church.
And doing trainings again.
Training.
You got to retrain. Every department needs to be retrained. We're getting new, having auditions for positions. It's going to be
all things new.
There you go. I'm trying not to say it, y'all, but it keeps coming out, y'all. God is causing us to LiVe again. So I'm excited about that. So during these weeks, again, please stay closely connected to us. We'll let you know which department we'll be doing what. If you can help us pack up stuff, but you can't drive it over there, thank you for helping us pack. If you can help us drive, whatever you can help us do. And then when we get in there, we're going to have to paint.
Yep.
We're going to have to set up stuff. We need the LiVe family to really say, hey, I believe in what God is doing at this church. This is not the only church God is moving, but it's the church where God has called me to serve and be part of. We need you all right now as we move into this next phase of our ministry. We finally got a home. We're very excited about it, y'all. So listen, again, we get the keys January 10th. Praise the Lord! That's amazing, y'all. We can shout, and we have shouted off of that. Then we're going to take 10 weeks to just make sure it is excellent. Make sure it is of kingdom standard. Make sure it's how we see us living. So we need your help during those 10 weeks, and we'll keep you posted. Stay connected to us. Until then, be blessed in the name of Jesus. Happy 2024. We cannot wait to see what God has in store for us this upcoming year. But y'all stay connected to us, and we'll make sure we'll keep you all updated as to what's going on every step of the way. It's a new day, y'all, but it's a good one. God bless you. We love you. To you and your families, be blessed. We pray for harmony in your homes. We pray for peace in your lives. We pray for God to prosper you as your soul prospers. Focus this year on prospering your soul. Prosper your soul. Get our emotions intact. Get our thoughts in order. Lord, in 2024, prosper our souls. And any other type of prosperity is easy. We give you glory. We give you praise and honor. We thank you for another year. We expect great things. In your name we pray. Amen. We love you, LiVe. Y'all stay connected, all right?
LiVe.